Half a mile of asphalt, a quarter mile to race on and a quarter mile to slow down in. Thousands of people, but with one idea, one dream, to build a hot rod that is swifter than any other hot rod in its class. The test of one car against another to determine the lowest elapsed time. So, here we are, 500 horsepower ready to push me down that quarter of a mile in less than 10 seconds. You don't drive, you aim. You aim and try to keep it straight. It's like threading a needle at a quarter of a mile, but it's really living.
Like a dream to me ever since I was 15. So hopefully one day I get picked up by a sponsor and help us get up there. I mean, if I do get picked up by a sponsor, it will be there quicker, you know what I mean? But for now, I'm working my way up.
Brothers Pawn and Chan are kind of special to us. They're sort of like lead men, and they've shown that they have a good work ethic, they're honest, and good family men. I noticed that they were working on this car a lot, and a cost estimate was put forth, and I agreed to work with them on some improvements on the car this season to see if we could get it under 10 seconds in the quarter. And we've been fortunate to have them here, the brothers.
The brother.
Oh, that's the brother.
That's tight, that's tight.
That looks very nice. It
looks cool, man. I love it. Thanks to US system.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome.
Thanks to the sponsor.
Thanks for the sponsor.
But we need some more sponsors.
What's on the back of this?
The brothers. That'll be me and my brother. Me, my brother and I.
Oh, by the way, we're going to cut out 12 o'clock. We got to go dyno. We got an appointment at 1:30. We got to put the car in the machine.
How long have you been racing for?
Since I was 15. Ever since I didn't have no driver license. My brother got me into it, and shoot, it's been what, about 9 years now, and I'm still doing it. I got addicted to racing. That's better than, you know, drugs and gang related stuff. I mean, racing keep me out in trouble.
Before we had the shop, we used to work at the brother's house in the backyard, you know. We didn't have no lift. We didn't have no lighting. We'd be back there trying to fix our cars with flashlights and all that. And we was like, you know, I was like, man, just hold on. I'm gonna go look for a building, man. I'm tired of this, you know. I'm tired of working out, laying down on the ground, working on a car. It's real hard. One day, Pawn and Chan's like, you know what? We're gonna get sponsored by Greg. I'm like, sponsors. They said, yeah, we're gonna try to hit nines. I'm like, you guys trying to hit nines? And I'm like, shoot, man, I'm, you know, all right, let's do it, you know?
Nope is about having fun and going fast, watching your friends go fast and having a good time.
Johnny, I'm a loud rap star, party hard like a rock star. Got Ty and Chris jamming on the guitar. Spit that high 60 bar, get them high like a weed bar. Beat fast, dance car, beat last, we stop. I'ma be famous on the show, stopping spree. Every show collecting fees, let them know I'm stacking cheese. Rich blood in me on stage, throw me money, got steak. Always got a clock, don't be bad that. How these haters ever think they gonna stop me? Mr. Ice, Boy, Rocky, Rocky, Mr. Knocky, Knocky, haters out. Roll your ass, let the pressure, baby. For perfection, for vibe, connection, feel the vibe. Be come on! Listen to the
run in the left-hand lane there
as
they cross the finish line at 10:65 at 120 miles an
hour.
Rod knocking? Yeah. Equal. Finally. We're done for the day.
Guys, we're done.
Sucks.
Alright, I'll call you in a little bit.
Hey, barbecue tonight. That's all you need to
start. We're done for the day, Chris. It's a wear and tear deal, you know.
What happened?
The rod knocked. I mean, the engine's about to blow. You push it, so we're gonna leave it the way it is. Take it home, tear it apart. We're here at Tulsa, Oklahoma for import face-off, and we're here early, kind of early. The gate open at 10 right now, it's about, what, 9-something? Yeah, we're here waiting. Like they said, early bird get a worm, but I don't know what the heck we're going to get today. Maybe a good time, you know? Maybe hopefully low 10s, very low, like 10, 10-1, 10-2. We'll see how it works out.
You brought the microwave?
Who brought a microwave? We did. We brought a shop fan, a generator, microwave, barbecue chicken from last night.
Okay, a little bit about Import Face Off. We started in 2001, just a group of street racers, a car club. We went to a lot of events in Texas and decided to host our own event in Louisiana. Nobody had ever stepped forward to do anything, so we did. hoping for a couple hundred people to show up, and to our surprise, we had 1,900 people show up. It was a huge success. Ever since then, we've been doing events. This is our 53rd event. We go all over the country. The series is just getting bigger and better.
It ran all right. We ran 1050 at 140 miles per hour. It's not doing its best, but we'll see how it turns out. Change out the plugs, get brand new plugs. Make sure we get a spark, you know. It's pouring rain, and I guess that's the end of the race for today. Yeah, I think they're gonna split the payout. Get something better than nothing, right?
That's right. If it's a $4,000 payout, everybody gets at least $500.
Nice.
That's not bad.
Gas, some gas, some food to go home.
Let's go, man.
You. Next. What was that one for?
I haven't
tuned the car
with the rollers yet. It made more power.
You, sir.
Good job, bud.
All right, what's the last name?
The longest one there.
The longest one?
Yeah.
This one?
That'll be
that's
it.
That's you, huh?
Yep.
All right. Well, if you could just go and sign your name.
What's like 8 people left or 7?
8.
8?
Yep. So that's 550. Just count it, make sure that's good, right?
All right, man.
Good job, man.
Yeah.
Appreciate you guys.
Yeah, we'll be here next year.
All right, sounds good. You guys have a good night.
You too. That's not bad. It's all right, man. I'm smiling. All right,
man.
All right, man. Catch you guys sometime, man.
All right, man.
Somebody.
Go home with some gas money. My dad was in military, you know, fighting communists. So communists took over, and he couldn't stay. So if he did, then they would have killed him. So we had to get away from Laos. You know, same time as he wanted the best for us too. You know, just like any parents want the best for the kid, right? To live the American dream, I guess.
The place that we live in there, it's like a camp. It's like no freedom, because it's like you stay in it's like a camp. You know, you stay under people's roof. Basically, the camp, it just you stay there before you get to come to America, because it's like a refugee, refugee camp.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
What was that like? I mean, how was that different than living in the United States?
It's basically you're in prison, but with a little bit of freedom, you know. Whatever you do, they keep you in check, make sure you don't, you know, break the rule.
You can't get in, get out.
Yeah, you can't, you know, speak freely, basically. Whatever you don't like, you have to keep it to yourself. I mean, if you open your mouth, not like in America, freedom of speech, you know, if you open your mouth, you know, you'd be gone the next day. That's how it is, you know what I mean? You know, there are limited rules and, you know, opportunities for foreign, you know, people like us to come out here, live the American dream, and make the best of it. And I think we're getting there, I think. it's like a dream, you know. You're in a camp, and then you never expect, it's like, you're not educated, like, how the outside world is. So you live in a little shack, and then, maybe a month later, you into this, new place with buildings and, airplanes and trains and cars. It's like, whoa, where I'm at, It's like, am I in heaven or what? You're pinching yourself. No, I'm still alive. it's just a shock.
Yet. It's supposed to be his birthday next week. We gotta get him drunk. See, he ain't tore up yet. He didn't start drinking more.
You're not tore up yet.
But I got nothing to say.
What's this right here?
Eat, drink.
Huh?
You drink, right?
This is the shit that white folks fall in love with.
What?
Asian barbecue right here.
Okay, chicken.
Dallas Motorplex, waiting in line, get tech. After we get tech, go get some qualifying run. I'm just relaxed, here to have fun. Since Greg can't be here, I gotta have fun for Greg.
Did you guys get a chance to go on the dyno?
No, we didn't have a chance. We call schedule and they call us at last minute to say they booked up and they way behind, so we got no choice but just come up here and leave it alone and mess a few things here and there, and we'll see how we do.
We're in Dallas, basically, the outskirts of Dallas, Ains, Texas, at the track, about to run the brother's car. Just got the boost set up, so see if it hope it works. I haven't got a chance to check it out and try it out yet, so this will be the first time doing the new setup. Let's hope for the best.
get them up on the line, check the tire, all the stuff. I tell them why I ordered that car, gut it. How can it be on Valkyra, you know what I mean?
What does it mean that it's gutted out?
They're in a different class. They're supposed to be in a hot rod class, and they threw them in a street class.
But what does gutted out mean? It's
gutted, no interior, the dash is cut out. It's basically, it's a weightless car that they're throwing in the street class.
Well, supposedly, hot rod's supposed to run with hot rod, you know what I mean?
And what makes a hot rod? I mean, what's the problem?
It's fully gutted, at least. My weight's been 500, and he weighs about at least 1,500. I mean, we told, you know, like, damn, we got to run with the hot rod. What he doing in my class, you know what I mean? I was like, damn, he got me first gear, and he got me pretty good about a car. So I just, you know, stay consistent. Second gear, wrap it up. Third gear, wrap it up. So I stopped putting on him. I was like, yeah, I got it. That's when I know, yeah, I'm out. No, I won, because I stayed on it, and he started falling back. I said, oh, something wrong with his car. And I just kept on, you know, focusing on the track. Came up on the top.
We're pulling the log out from after the run he just did, and just checking through what the engine was doing and the speed and everything. It tells us the boost levels. Let's make sure everything's up and good.
Now we're gonna be up against the fastest guy in the damn track.
Going up against the guy the fastest guy in Texas. No, I'm not ready yet. I need about 3 more on your horse. God damn. He's gonna eat me up alive.
That's what you said about the last guy.
Yeah, but this guy's different.
He broke his record too.
What?
9-2?
He broke his record twice today.
Yeah.
What was his record before?
9-4. Now 9-3, 9-2 already.
I was still 11, and you know, I mean, I didn't even have enough time to, you know, as a child, didn't have enough time to spend with my father. I mean, growing up, just as my mom, you know, my brother, that's the only guy I look up towards is my brother, you know.
You know, after his father died, you know, and Pawnee, he's the oldest, you know, brother, and he promised his dad that he's gonna take care of his, you know, his brothers. So, and he's doing his job. He's doing a great job, you know, being a brother, you know, and being a good husband for me and my kids, you know. So it's just good. And he's, you know, he's a hardworking guy, both of them.
I mean, we've been struggling since my dad passed away, and, you know, it's been hard on us. But, you know, we struggle. We know one day it's gonna be good for us. And here we are. We're trying to, you know, make it there.
Hey, doing, Greg. Chan.
Hello.
Colin. Glad you guys could make it so we could go over the upcoming racing season. Okay. What is our goal for this year in the racing season? What do you want to do? What do you hope to accomplish?
Well, actually, our goal was in last year, but we start kind of late. I mean, you know, it towards almost the end of the season, so. A goal to hit 9, but you know, we got a lot of stuff going on, tuning problem, and you know, maybe part why, you know, we get it delayed all the time, you know, we get it late.
Let's get it done early. Let's get out to KCIR and get this thing running and get ahead of it where we know where it's going to run before we go to the event. Let's get under 10 seconds. You want to do it?
Well, I mean, like I said,
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
That's what I live for.
You think he'd be like available like next 15 minutes, 20 minutes? Because, actually we calling about the proposal that we sent him and he told us to call back, that's why. Sure. It's not available. Speak to David Quarrel, please. My name is Pawn. I believe you speak to Chris Williamson, and we try to return your call. Okay, thank you. Bye. He got a lot of customer on the line, so he get me, he want my phone number, so he could call right back as soon as he clear the line out, because, you know, it's really important call to him, so he's gonna call me right back. So he say he's like, oh, okay. He's like, he want, the phone number, so I give him my phone number. He gonna call back.
Upon is fabricating up a turbo manifold. It's gonna be bottom mount, but the turbo's gonna be sitting in the front of the car. Now he's trying to measure all the pipings and see how everything's gonna fit. This gonna be the first look of this turbo setup here in Kansas City, where the turbo sits in front of the car. Nobody here in Kansas City has it. So, it's only done here by PNC Fab. PNC Fab is Pawn & Chan Fabrication. That's how you do it.
Mainly P. C just watching.
Mainly P.
C just watching. C is a nice C.
So what's going on here?
Well, actually, we try to make the manifold. Right now, we tag it up, see how the turbo gonna sit the way we want it.
Okay.
And then we're gonna go from there. Right now, we got one leg, but we got three more legs to put on. So that's what we're working on.
I'm just looking. You gotta meet the driver expectation. You know what I mean?
So this is what it's gonna look like.
Yep.
With
the intercoolers and stuff on there, so now we're gonna try to see how it's gonna look like.
Another piece for the manifold.
Right now, my man Pawn right here is just going through his head, visualizing what's going on, taking the rounds, connecting it, all the bins. Everything's basically made from scratch, as you can see. Got Chan over here holding it down, cutting all the pieces together. Basically a jigsaw puzzle coming to life.
Well, what we did here is we got a bunch of dents and dings, so we bonded it up. We're trying to get it ready, prep it for paint. Maybe it's in about maybe a week and a half, so I'm trying to make this thing look nice, Gotta have show and go.
Check
Oh, we got a t-shirt from sponsored the energy drink.
Brando sent us some energy drink and some t-shirt, and we're gonna try it out. Tastes good too.
Oh man, you got one some?
Look at me, I'm a spokesman. As you can see, we're sanding it down. You know, right now, it's still under construction. As you can see, like what, 3-4 different color. You got white, metal, pink, green, you know, but that's part of the procedure, you know, getting it down, sanded, you know, prepping it. So that way, take it down to a friend of ours, Tony. So he won't have to do too much work on it, you know what I mean? Just get it ready for him as much as we can, and you know, yeah, it's ready to go.
Did you see what I'm hauling?
Ready to get this car painted.
You think it's gonna look good?
Of course it's gonna look good. The mean green machine.
You excited about it?
Yep, I am. Excited for everything. Excited to hit 9? Going to, at least.
Man, what we got here? It looks pretty good. What are we painting it for?
I don't know, man. It looks good to you. I don't know. I want to look better, man.
This is Tony. He's going to be the person that paint the cars and see what he could do for us.
Make it look good.
Well, I'm going to leave it up to you now.
Cool.
So,
take care of it.
Yeah.
Make it look good.
Let me know when you're ready.
Sweet.
When it's done.
Sweet.
Give us a call.
Today all day we're gonna celebration, and tomorrow we're gonna have the parade. If you want to enjoy with us, we will do every year over here, and welcome to Sacramento, Texas. Thank you.
fried rice, lao sausage, pork sausage, kor mee, fried noodles, and that's lap, and that's a chicken feet salad, and that one is nam khao, and that one is suk lamai, and that one is keng lamai, and tom kheng nai. Yeah. That's you know, all Lao food. Oh, this one is kamang. And it's a Lao dessert with this stuff in bamboo shoot, you know. And they bake it like what you see right now. So it tastes pretty good. They got coconut in there, some black bean, and some sticky rice.
It's called Song Nam Pot. Is we're leaving with a blessing, watering all the Buddha statues with the holy water. And then once we finish off, we put the remaining of the holy water on our heads. Right, Bob?
That's what we got right here.
That's what we got right here.
From the
water.
Blessing the
once
Buddha.
Once we leave the temple, we leave with a blessing. That's about it.
Don't drink that. It's not for drinking. We're here at Tony's place. We're down here to talk to Tony about our car, see what he thinks about our setup. And as you can see, all his trophy he won, you know, he's gonna help us tune his car, get us down there into the nines. He's the man.
I helped a lot of guys around here try to get in the nines, and nobody could do it. You know, every time we went out, everybody 10-2, 10-3, 10-0. When I started driving this car, the first time we went out, we went 10-1. And then made a couple changes, went 9-8, and the car ran nines every single time we went out after that. So it's just a matter of being organized, planning everything out. You put things together right, and you go to the track, and it works.
Can I take a picture with you?
All right.
He's gonna be a legend, so I gotta take a picture of him.
One, two, and three.
Well, we just talked to Tony. And he kind of guide us to see what we need, exactly what we need, and what to do to the cars, and what to get, all the part. And we sent him the list, but you know, he go through it, and he said, you know, it looking good, but just little couple more things that he, you know, recommend us to get. We're gonna go back and simmer our part, motors, and all the stuff, and then hopefully, looking at about 2 weeks or 3 weeks from now, and then we're gonna hit back down here and let Tony tune the car.
Get a nice second pass. I could days off and dream about it.
We're all like family, really. Pawn, he's basically the older brother of the group, the wise one, the one that we give him much respect. And Chan, he's outgoing, we like to party, and the only thing we have in common is we love cars. That's our passion, that's our life.
I just painted the brother's car, and they're here to see it, so see what they say about it.
Hey,
Looking good, Tony.
You like it? It's hard work, man.
First game, we looked like junk, ain't it? Nah, it looked like gold. Let me get one of my black head out real quick.
And now we're gonna take it back to the shop and start putting engines and all the parts in. Thanks to Tony.
Call me. Need a paint job? I'm the man.
What in the world is going on here?
Be on a trailer to haul our car.
To build a trailer for your car.
Yep. But, almost there.
Almost there?
Yeah. Putting piece by piece.
We just like fabricating. I got this idea. I was like, hey, Paul, let's do our own trailer. He's like, okay, let's do it. Just like that, three hours ago, it was like in pieces. Now it's all tacked up. I mean, we basically know how to do everything. All we need is go buy the axles and the leaf spring. The rest of it is all in Pond's head.
So do you have to get a license plate for it?
Well, after it's done, then we're gonna take it to a highway patrol to get it inspected. And
is it even legal to build your own trailer?
Why not? How you get a trailer if you don't build them? You know what I mean? Somebody has to build them. If it comes apart, I'll quit as a welder. I'll probably go work at McDonald's or something. But it's not gonna break. I've been a welder for 6 years and nothing has break on me yet, so I'm good. We got done tacking all the trailer up, so now we're welding it. It should be done in about a couple hours, but we're taking our time. We're kind of tired right now. The trailer we're building inside is kind of like this one, but now it's gonna be brand new. And as you can see, this one's kind of beat up a little bit because, you know, it needs to carry material and stuff like that. So yeah. After we're done with the one inside, we're gonna paint it black, just like this one. And we're gonna eliminate all those railings, side railing. It's hard for me to get up, you know. I'm only 5'5". It's like, you know, it's not for big guys out there, they're like, oh, that's nothing. But to us, it's a lot accomplished, you know what I mean? For little guys like us, you know, yeah, working 9 to 5 and doing all this, it's amazing, you know? We just love to build our own stuff. I mean, just like the trailer, we could go out there and buy it for like, what, $3,500 to $3,800. But instead, we build from scratch. It's less than $2,000. Save us the rest of the money. I'll spend on the car some more.
And right now, Fonda's side welding, and he's outside cutting the brackets for the lights. Other than that, we're just trying to get the car done, waiting for a couple more parts, the blow-off valve, and the wiring for the
MW, that's about it. After that, we're heading down to Texas.
We sent the transmission case in and we were backed up for like 3 weeks. 3 weeks wasn't bad, but you know, we were on a deadline, so we had to extend our appointment a little bit with Tony, so here we are tonight. We're ready to go.
Yeah, that's all the
homies
right there.
Come on, yo, hurry up. We gotta go. It's about to rain my car, man. I just got it waxed. Come on, bro. I know that shit hit my car.
It ain't no game, nigga.
T1 race development. We just unload the car and Tony's working on it. Strap it down. We're getting it tuned. Ready. Excited. You can hear the sound. You hear that? You can hear the engine roaring over there. But yeah, we're ready to get the party started. Let's go.
Hi, I'm Tony Palo from T1 Race Development. We're here at my shop today to take the brother's car, who barely runs, and it's going to leave here making over 800 horsepower.
I'm connecting to the computer right now. We're going to pull the map out of there and see what's in it and see how much work it needs before we get started with anything.
For me, it's about going out there and doing better than I did last time. I like the competitiveness of racing, but more than anything, I like to push the envelope and do stuff that nobody's done. And so if I go out every time and go faster than I went the last time out, I'm happy. Wins are great and going rounds is great, but ultimately I'm doing this to learn more about these cars, develop products, push the envelope further. So for me, it's about going as fast as I can. The computer controls everything on these cars. It controls everything ignition related, everything fuel related, everything boost related. So the programming of the computer is obviously very important. It only does what you tell it to, and if you don't tell it to do the right thing, it doesn't. So we go in, we calibrate all the sensors, we make sure everything's reading properly, start working on the fuel tables to get the car to start and idle, and then we start working on the additional fuel tables to get the car to drive okay. This is just light throttle, normal driving. And then from there, we start making full throttle pulls. We're adjusting how much fuel goes in the engine, when the spark events happen, how much boost goes in the engine. And at the end of the day, the goal is to make it run properly and make a lot of power. We're just getting warmed up.
Thank you.
What's you guys' best dyno run so far until today?
Before we made like 629, 630 on 24, 25 pound. Now it's like 25 pound, we at 693. It's good.
So the boost goes up, power's gonna go up, and you guys expect to go towards 800, right?
Yeah.
Maybe even over?
That's all to Tony.
Millions of people that are gonna watch this movie are totally rooting for you, Tony.
Alright.
What do you think about that?
I can do it.
775. I'm excited.
Hey, Tony,
that's
say,
pretty good.
Tony, say what number you want. What number you want, you're gonna put it in. How many horsepower you want, he said.
Now I'm gonna go home and grow bigger balls. So I won't be scared to drive this damn thing.
That's why you make the big bucks, huh?
That's right.
I'm excited. That's like a dream come true, you know what I'm saying? Woo. 819. God, that's a lot of horse. Like I said, I'm gonna go home, grow bigger balls, and learn how to drive this sucker on the track.
First few runs were pretty good. We had some boost control problems. We got those worked out real quick, and then once we got the boost turned up, everything went by nice and smooth. There's a lot that goes into preparing a car to do what this car did. And there's a lot of things that can go wrong in doing it. But the fact that everything went as smooth as it did today says a lot about how the car was put together and how the car was tuned, because this could have easily taken all day and not been done. There's so many pieces of the puzzle that have to be complete to make one of these cars perform the way we want them to. And they obviously know how to build a car. They didn't have the right guidance on the parts to buy, and I could only assume the tuning wasn't quite up to par because the car didn't run what it should. But now I think we have all the pieces of the puzzle, and once they get familiar with driving the car and setting the car up the track, the car is going to be a big contender.
That's great.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Hey man, thanks for being in my movie, dude.
Thank you.
Appreciate it, man.
Last year we ran into a lot of problems. It got to the point I'm like, damn, I'm about to give up. But then, you know, when you get to that point, you just can't, you know. You just like, you just gotta go over that, you know. Overcome that, and here we are. We overcame that, and look at us this year. I mean, together as a team, we like, you know, we tight, you know, we help each other out, and look at the result. I mean, my boy Lucky's always here, you know, Hector, my brother, you know, Johnny, always here for us, helping us, and the car turned out great. frustrating. Damn. Shit don't run right.
What happened to it? You just got it tuned.
Well, the first run was on low boost. And then the second run, the vehicle speed sensor wasn't working. Third run, tried to do it again, put the vehicle speed sensor back on, but ran down the track. I guess the car was too low, shredded up the slicks. So we're $300 down the hole now, but I don't think we're gonna make Chicago. It's gonna be a long season. It's definitely gonna be a long season.
He was like, honey, this is my dream. This is something that is gonna be on my mind. Like, I'm gonna be like, what if, you know, what if I could make it to the big time? Like, and I was like, are you sure? He's like, it's important to me, honey, you know? I was like, okay, we're gonna make a deal then. Okay, if you wanna go into racing, then you can spend so much money, but I'm gonna ask you for some time with me. Me and Sadie would get pissed off at the car. Sometimes we want to kick it. Because it spent more time with them and money and everything. We just want to kick the car sometimes. It's so funny. From that point on, he was like, I'm serious about this, honey. It's my dream. And I was like, okay, fine. As long as you keep your part, and okay, I'll keep my part.
We was at the track last Wednesday, and then
the car was running great.
First, when he got up the line, he did a good burnout. I thought it was going to be a 9-second pass.
I got off the hole hard. 60 foot was good. I was like, man, this is going to be a good run.
Yeah, he got a good reaction time. It was 0.15. Good reaction time, almost got a red light.
I thought I missed gear, but then I throw it in again. I was like, nah, something's wrong. So I just let off and let it cruise.
But then I saw him launch off on the muscle car.
He goes and launches, got ahead of the Mustang, and then all of a sudden,
pop, blew up.
And just goes bow, he's out. He just goes down the track.
The muscle car ate him up.
And so, of course, the muscle car won.
So I was like, oh man, something's wrong with the car.
It just blew out second gear.
That broke the second gear.
He come back and say that the second gear blew out.
Came back, told us the second gear blew up.
Luckily, the rest of the gear is fine. Just second gear was bad.
So we gotta fix the problem.
And so we had to come back here and fix it.
We're Asian, we'd like to do things on the floor, you know? That's why we got a rough knee.
Can you show me what happened?
This is all the pieces to the second gear.
Those are the teeth?
Yeah.
The synchro?
Yeah.
You broke them?
Yeah, we broke them.
And then now we take it apart, and spider gears all broke, so all the 8 teeth are broke off from second gear, so now we find all the pieces in, and we're going to take it apart and call the transmission company, and then hopefully they send us a new one in time.
We called G-Force about the transmission, let them know what happened to the part, and he okay with it, and they're gonna ship us a new one. They said this one they're gonna stand behind their products, and they're gonna help us out with the part, and they say they're gonna get it out here tomorrow. So we get the part tomorrow, and we're gonna put it back in and ready to go.
Oh yeah, that's a good shot of it. All right, point to the broken parts.
There's all the broken parts right here. This is how it's supposed to look. With all the teeth.
Well, keep us away from trouble.
You know, we don't go around, you know, look for trouble. We just do our thing. You know, we do it, you know, we take whatever challenge. We you know, we want something to challenge us, and we want to beat it.
I can't seem to finish fourth gear, I don't know why.
Yeah.
It does the same thing.
It did it?
I shift early, and it hits like, and it cuts off. And still ran 10.5, 127 miles an hour.
114 again too.
That's hard. It pulled hard. First, second, third, it pulled hard.
It looped the signal. Let me move it out to 30. One more run.
We got hands.
We got until 10 o'clock, until they close.
What time is it right now?
9:30. 9:15.
Oh, I'm disappointed with this fourth gear shit. Oh, I don't think we're gonna make it. Car keep backing up. Oh, I guess no event on Sunday.
We're not going in for a face off?
Nope.
Well, what I want to see it happen is we want to break a nine, you know, in our own hometown, and never knows. I mean, that's why we want to, you know, work hard and get the car, dial it in, figure out a problem before the event come up, and try to make it happen.
M9C. Yeah.
Britain signed, and I'll get your bracelets.
What's up, Chris?
What's that you got?
Well, we got a sign, release your life, so you could be inside a pit crew, so, you know, in case something happened, I guess. Other than that, they won't let you go in a burnout box.
Ready to do this, Chris?
He got off the line, right? He went woo to the wall, he came back out. It went woo to the wall, he came back out again. I mean, the track is stick only one side. Stick only on the right. Oh, he didn't let off though. He would have let off. That shit scared the out of me.
I'm looking at
I think my ball just shriveled.
You didn't check the time pressure on the other side.
I did.
Damn.
I checked both of them, fool.
Brand new slick, pull up again. Damn. I was fighting it, I was pulling to the right. I think we messed up the tire already. The size ate up.
How about your knife, Chris? How about your knife?
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
make it obvious.
You gotta run without bumper.
Oh, I mean, you take it off.
No, I ain't gonna trip taking it out. You can't run with that thing. You're gonna blow it up.
Yeah.
Had a bad run. Tore up the slick. And I'm not too happy right now.
Well, it's trashed the slick, so I don't know if we're gonna make one more pass. Hopefully nothing happened to the tire, the slick. It doesn't look too good. Today is a good ass weather too, you know what I'm saying? You think we're gonna find a weather like this again next week?
No.
There we go, run into a damn problem again.
Safe to race on?
Well, it's 50-50. We don't know how deep did it cut inside.
Okay, one more run. We're going left end this time.
Kansas City boy? Woo! Pop! He's happy! Yeah! Hell yeah!
Hell yeah!
Woo! I felt that too!
Wait, stop celebrating!
Yeah!
Hot bottles!
Woo! Hell yeah! Hell yeah, Bill!
You wanna do it again now, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Damn! I got down there, I'm like, damn, why is he falling back? I'm like, oh, hell yeah! Woo! That shit was good. I'm pissed too. They all that shit like, bah, 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 bah. I'm like, hell yeah.
A 9-8?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thanks, man.
Daddy. What do you got in there?
It's a GSR turbo.
Big ass turbo?
Yeah. This is in the front, you can take a look at. Yeah.
Good
job. Yeah, Chris! We did it!
Guitar, spit that high 60 bar, get them high like a weed bar.
far. Beat fast, NASCAR, heat last, we start. I'ma be famous on the show, stopping spree. Every show collecting fees, let them know I'm stacking cheese. Rich blood in me, on stage, stole me money. Gotta stay cocky, step back, always got a clock with me. Bad debt, how these haters ever think they gonna stop me? Mr. Ice Boy, Rocky, Rocky, Mr. Docky, Docky, haters out. Roll your ass my direction, baby, move for perfection. Provide connection, feel the vibe. Come on, listen to the radio got a movement. And the way that she's moving, and the way that she's grooving. Man, she do it on the regular, a regular at a club, man. Every gentleman wanna go sex her up, man. Listen to the radio got a movement. And the way that she's moving, and the way that she's grooving. Man, she do it on the regular, and the regular at a club, man. Every gentleman wanna go sex her up. Bloodline, rip shows at all times. You ain't got swagger like mine.
Yeah, it's the headbangers ball in this one, huh? I got the heads ringing. You already know how I do it. I see you, Ty. I see you, Chris. Good looking out, fam. Come on, do your thing.